Dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome back in our biology period. So today in this video we will start our new lesson, and the name of the lesson is what? Nutrition in animals. Okay, so let's start the lesson. In our previous lesson we have discussed about the nutrition in plants, how the plants are taking their nutrition with the help of the different ways. So in today's lesson we will discuss about nutrition in animals. It means what? How the animals are taking their nutrients, or how the animals fulfill their need of the nutrition. Okay, so let's start. What is meant by exactly animal nutrition required? Let's see. Animal nutrition includes nutrients requirement mode of intake of food and its utilization in the body. Okay, so what exactly happens in the animal nutrition? The animal nutrition includes nutrient requirement, they requires the nutrient, mode of intake of the food. The different organisms are having different types of the mode to take the food, okay, or the mode of intake of food and its utilization in the body. So they requires the nutrients, how they are taking the nutrients in a different way, and how that nutrients are get utilized by the body. All these things comes under what? Animal nutrition, or nutrition in animals. Okay, so animal nutrition includes nutrients requirements, mode of intake of food and its utilization in the body. Okay, so as we know, the plants are the basic units, or the plants are the basic food atoms which are present on the earth, and each and every living organism directly or indirectly depends on the green plants for the need of their food. Okay, so there are the certain organisms, those who directly feed on the green plants, and there are the certain organisms, those who are indirectly depends on the plants. Means what? They are eating the animals, those who are eating the green plants. Okay, so in this way each and every living organisms are depends on the green plants for their food. In this way they are getting their different nutrients and the mode of intake of food and its utilization in the body. Okay, so in our previous classes we have discussed about the different components of the food. There are the different components of the food, and they are only called as what? Nutrients. So there are carbohydrate, fats, protein, vitamins and minerals. All these are the different nutrients which our body required. Okay, so among all these components, among all these nutrients, the carbohydrate is the main or the more amount of the nutrient that we are having in our diet. Okay, so this carbohydrate, those whatever the carbohydrate we are having in our diet, that carbohydrate is in a complex substance, or it is in a complex form, and that complex form of the carbohydrate our body cannot get utilized. Okay, or our body cannot utilize that complex carbohydrate. Okay, so it is necessary to convert that complex carbohydrate into the simpler substance. Okay, so that complex substance, or what? Complex carbohydrate, it is necessary to convert into the simpler substance, and that process is only called as what? Digestion. Okay, so what is meant by exactly digestion? The breakdown of complex components of food into simpler substances is called digestion. Okay, so the breakdown of the complex components of food into simpler substances, and that process is called as what? Digestion. And which is the complex component? Carbohydrate. That carbohydrate cannot get utilized by our body, and that is the reason we have to, or our body have to make it into the simpler form. So see, in this way we can say that so it is the complex substance, it is necessary to get converted into the simpler substance. Okay, okay, so let's discuss the next point, that is what? Different ways of taking food. So in the first point only we have discussed that there are the different ways in that the animals are taking food. Okay, or they are intake of the food. The different animals are taking the food inside in a different ways. let's discuss that. First one we'll see about the human being. So as we know, the human beings are using their hands to put the food in their mouth. Okay, so with the help of their hands and the mouth, they are having their food. Next one is that ruminants. So the ruminants like cow, buffalo, goat, okay, all these are what? Animals, those who are having the green grass and they are having their food directly into their mouth. Okay, they are taking the food directly into their mouth. Next one is there, that is what? Paramecium. Okay, so this paramecium is what? Unicellular microorganism. And this paramecium is having hair like structure on its body, and that hair like structure is called as what? Cilia. Okay, so that hair like structure is present on the body of a paramecium, and that hair like structure is called as what? Cilia. So the body of the paramecium is totally covered with the cilia, and they are doing continuously movement. Okay, that hairs or that cilia are doing continuously movement, which helps the paramecium to absorb the food into their mouth or to take the food into their mouth with the flow of the water. Okay, so in this way, with the help of the cilia, we can say that the paramecium is having their food. Next one we will discuss about the insect. Okay, so there are the different insects, or there are the vast variety of the insects are present on the earth. We can say the mosquito is there, different bees are there, honeybees are there. Okay, so all these are the insects are having the feeding tube. Okay, all these insects are having the feeding tube, and the feeding tube is nothing but called as what? Proboscis. Okay, so with the help of the proboscis, they are sucking the nutrients from the other organism. So they are sucking the nutrients from the different food atoms. Okay, so this sucking is nothing but that, like that we are having the cold drinks with the help of the straw. How the processes happen whenever we are having the cold drinks with the help of the straw? The same processes happens with the help of the proboscis. Okay, so here what we have discussed, that the different organisms are having the different ways to take in food. Okay, so this is all about what? Digestion. What is meant by digestion? The breakdown of the complex component of food into simpler substance is called digestion. Different animals, different organisms are having different ways of taking food. In that we have discussed about human being, ruminants, paramecium and insects. Okay, also we can say that birds are there, birds are having the beak. So with the help of the beak, they are having the food and they are directly swallowing that. Okay, so there are the different ways also we can say that we can say the scraping is there, chewing is there, symphoning, nothing but what? Like a proboscis, means sucking. Okay, capturing and swallowing is there, and the sponging means what? Absorbing food nutrients, and also we can say that sucking. Okay, so these are the also different modes in that the organisms are taking their nutrients or fulfill their need of nutrients. Okay, so this is all about today. We'll discuss the next point in the next video. Today, thank you.